Hey there, welcome back to our Power Platform tutorial series. I'm Diani, and today I'm going to show you on how to enable and use Copilot in your model-driven apps. You might be wondering, on what's the use cases for enabling Copilot for your model-driven apps? Well, Copilot is your personal assistant and a productivity booster.
Jarvis, you up?
For user only.
Imagine automatically filling in fields suggested by Copilot based on previous entries. Reduce manual data input time and errors with Copilot's predictive capabilities. Gain valuable insights with Copilot's analysis of your previous data to optimize data quality. Some of Copilot's features and capabilities includes personalized recommendations, where Copilot analyzes user interactions and provide tailored suggestions for improved workflows. It helps users discover hidden opportunities within the app and optimize their operations. Plus, it adapts to users' individual preferences, offering customized assistance. Before we jump in, hit that subscribe button, smash the thumbs up button, and share your thoughts in the comment section down below. Your support helps keep this content coming. I'm in my model-driven app, and Copilot is not enabled yet. Once we enable it, Copilot will be accessible on the side pane. To enable Copilot, go to the Power Platform Admin Center. On the sitemap, click Environment. Select and open the environment where we want to enable Copilot. For this demo, it's my QA environment. Click Settings. On the Settings page, expand the Product section and click Features Hyperlink. The first option you'll see is Copilot. By default, it's set to off. Toggle the switch to on. In the drop-down below, set it to on to allow users to analyze data using the AI-powered chat experience in both model-driven apps and Canvas apps. Locate AI Form Field Assistant section. In the drop-down, select all users immediately. Scroll all the way down to the bottom of the page and click Save to apply changes. Now that Copilot is enabled, go back to the model-driven app. If you don't see any changes, refresh your browser window. Once refreshed, you'll notice on the side pane is now visible, featuring the Copilot icon. Click on the icon to explore its capabilities. For example, navigate to the contact view and Copilot will guide you there. Let's switch to the rooms view. Here I have 7 records. Open Copilot on the side pane and ask how many family rooms do I have. Copilot will analyze and count the records for you. Imagine how helpful this is if you are dealing with a large data set and don't have time to develop a report. You can even ask Copilot to display those family records. From the results, you can click directly on records to view them. Or use the Show All on Page option to bring up the filtered view. You will also notice that we are not limited only to the Copilot chat experience, but on our views as well, we have the Copilot icon to show us that we can use our own weights to actually filter the view. Like for instance, I can use my own weights to filter out those who work for Magomani Construction. And once you hit enter, you will notice it brings up all those who work for Magomani Construction. I can also find out who is a developer for Magomani Construction. And as you can see, Kevin is the developer for Magomani Construction. To verify this, when I click on Kevin, I will see on the form that it says job title is developer for Kevin Holman. On our active contacts view, when we click on the new button, you will immediately notice there is a new notifications. This is a Copilot notifications which comes up with pre-populated suggestions when trying to capture new data, looking at our behavior on how we've been capturing data. For instance, most of the records that I have in the system, I've been capturing them with these field values: Midrand, Gauteng, 1618, and South Africa. I can select to individually click on one of them or actually accept all the suggestions that Copilot has come up with, and it will pre-populate them. For my new record, reducing the amount of time where I would be capturing the same data over and over again. Though Copilot is great to use, there is still some limitations on it. Like for instance, you cannot just tell it to create or update records. Like in this case, I'm trying to tell Copilot to create a record. When I hit enter, you'll see that the results coming back from Copilot, it says I cannot answer that question, meaning that it is unable to add or update data in the system. And form fill assistant feature is still limited to field types that are text, numeric, choice, and date, and fields that have column security aren't currently supported. There is specific languages as well. You can go to Microsoft Learn to see the list of languages that are currently supported. And suggestions are generated for fields only in the main forms and quick create forms.
By using Copilot, you'll unlock hidden potential, such as increased productivity, enhanced efficiency, and improved data accuracy. So get started with enabling Copilot in your model-driven apps today. Integrate Copilot within your existing model-driven apps and unlock a new era of productivity and efficiency with this transformative AI solution.
If you've enjoyed this in-depth walk, give us a like, share your thoughts in the comment section, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.